at the moment. This Terrace group is up shipped up in lane one. They're doing a fantastic job on the inside. It's good to see Terrace doing well. TSS aren't going to go down, and that's State Light group. Jeez, they look polished on the far side. BBC, streaked by a year 10 up, are doing a fantastic performance in getting right up that TSS crew. Terrace on the inside, in front of Churchill. TSS in third place, BBC in second. BBC are now challenging State High. Walk rides are in full swing. Terrace, they're getting stuck right into it. It's Barragatta. I reckon they want it. It's Barragatta. TSS, they're coming through. State High on the far side. BBC with the Year 10 Australian. It's going to be tight. Terrace.
Go on, boy.
TSS.
Go on, boy.
BBC, State High. There is about half a second splitting them. My money's on Terrace. Here they come. Terrace. Canvas by lead. They've done it. It's Barragatta.
Go, boys.
First place. The one by lead from TSS. State High.
Go, boys.
Woo! rowing left that all of these guys do have is the Open First Eight. The Open First Eight of 2005. They've lent a shed manfully in the simple facts with the Open Twos and Threes and Fours. The work they've done has been simply enormous. The level of commitment, both in time and physical nature, the level of determination, their land training, their water work, it simply has been a sensational effort. How have they been going? They've won a first stage race, which was a fantastic race, in an incredibly tight finish. I think last weekend there was about a length between first and fifth. It was a great crew, it was a great race that they've done, and they've got a mixture of interesting characters. They've got two young fellows from the grade 11 in their eight. Interesting guy on the end there, Daniel Wolter, who I think took up rowing this year for the first time and on the back of about 20 sculling lessons with assistance and coaching from his dad, who rode for the state, has made the eight this year. I'll get John Camphin, our captain of boats, to introduce his crew to you. The average weights of some of our competitive crews are in excess of 90 and 95 kilos. They're big, big boys. Yet these guys, I think, are around about 75, 76. They're nowhere near as big, but what they lack in physical height and probably weight, brawn, they make up in pure technical finesse. They are one of the best finesse crews that you'll see on the water. They are a very committed and determined crew and certainly are in good shot at this year's Hidden River. I like the fact that we don't pick our eights anymore in these days simply on size. We pick them on raw talent and ability, and the simple fact that probably some of the shorter guys have made this crew is a testament to the drive and determination and their own personal will. So congratulations to you gentlemen. It's been a great effort for yourself so far.
Come on, boys, can you believe it?
Come on. Come on, boys.
They're coming.
They're looking good. Come on, boys. Lift it hard. Row hard. Come on, boys. Don't let them down. Go. Keep it going. Get into it. Oh, look at Churchy, mate. Come on, Terrace. Come on, go. Oh, look at Churchy. Come on, boys. Body in it. Go, son. Churchy and Terrace, mate. Come on, boys, lift!
Southport of the
front, mate. How do they, mate?
Don't give up, boys. Get that third. Yes.
Oh, good race. Good race.
They gave it every shot.
Didn't they? They
gave it every
shot. A great race.
Jono's happy. Jono's happy.
They did very well.
Yep, I'm sure.
Very proud of that.
Trish and John and everybody else have been so proud of their kids. Yeah.